Good morning, students. In the previous class, we have completed the grammar and vocabulary part of the lesson Attitude is Altitude. I hope you remember the story of that lesson. In that we have learned about Nick Vujicic, who succeeded in his life despite of his disabilities. And we have completed that story part and all the grammar and vocabulary. So today we are going to learn a new lesson which is from B reading. That is, every success story is also a story of great failures. Failure is the highway to success. Tom Watson Sr. said, if you want to succeed, double your failure rate. So, here, what they say is, failure is the highway to success. Means to succeed in your life, failure is the highway. Here, one person, who? Tom Watson Sr., he says that, if you want to succeed, double your failure rate. So he say that if we want to succeed in our life, we have to double our failure rate. Means if we fail, then only we will know the value of success. So he says that if you want to succeed, double your failure rate. If you study history, you will find that all stories of success are also stories of great failures. But people don't see the failures. They only see one side of the picture and they say that person got lucky. He must have been at the right place at the right time. Normally, if we see stories of history, we will find that all stories of success are also stories of failures, great failures. But normally we will not see those failures. But we will say that that person is lucky and he must have been at the right place at the right time. Let me share someone's life history with you. This was a man who failed in business at the age of 21, was defeated in a legislative race at age 22, failed again in business at age 24, overcame the death of his sweetheart at age 26. Had a nervous breakdown at age 27, lost a congressional race at age 34, lost a senatorial race at age 45, failed in an effort to become vice president at age 47, lost a senatorial race at age 49, and was elected president of the United States at age 52. This man was Abraham Lincoln. Here we have someone's life history. Who is Abraham Lincoln? He was a man who failed in business at the age of 21. Was defeated in a legislative race at age 22. Again, he failed in his business at age 24. Overcame the death of his sweetheart. Overcame means to defeat or succeed in controlling or dealing with something. Means he has controlled the pain of losing his sweetheart at the age of 26. Had a nervous breakdown at age 27. Lost a congressional race at age 34, lost a senatorial race at age 45, failed in an effort to become vice president at age 47. He lost a senatorial race at age 49 and was elected president of the United States at age 52. See how many times he has failed in his attempts, but finally he elected as the president of United States at the age of 52. About whom he is the man? Abraham Lincoln. Would you call him a failure? He could have quit, but Lincoln defeat was a detour and not a dead end. So, shall we call him a failure? No, because after so many attempts at the age of 52, he was elected as president of United States. He could have quit, means he would have stopped trying, but he didn't. He was trying and trying. So, finally, after so many attempts, he was elected as the president of the United States. So, what they say, but to Lincoln, defeat was a retour and not a dead end. Retour means a road or route that is used when the usual one is closed. So, when a way to success is blocked, normally we are on the way to our school, while we are coming, if that road is blocked, we will take an alternate road and we will reach to school. In the same way, the way to success also, if you have tried once and if you have lost, you have to try in another way, but you shouldn't stop. The same thing, Abraham Lincoln also, he tried but he didn't give up. In 1913, Lee DeForest, the inventor of the Triodes tube, was charged by the district attorney for using fraudulent means to mislead the public into buying stocks of his company by claiming that he could transmit the human voice across the Atlantic. He was publicly humiliated. Can you imagine where would be without his invention? So here, another man, before we have learned about Abraham Lincoln. Here in 1913, Lee DeForest, he is the inventor of Triodes tube. Triodes tube means a triode is an electronic amplification tube having three active electrodes. It is invented in 1906. The triode vacuum tube was the first electronic amplification device. This invention founded the electronic age, making possible amplified radio technology and long distance telephony. So he invented the triode tubes. He was charged by the district attorney. District attorney means a lawyer, for using fraudulent means to mislead the public into buying stocks of his company by claiming that he could transmit the human voice across the Atlantic. So he was humiliated. Humiliated means to make someone feel ashamed or stupid. So can we imagine where we would be without his invention? He has invented Triodes tube. By that, he was charged by whom? District attorney. Attorney means a lawyer. He said that you have created a fraudulent means to mislead the public and to invest in your company. So by that, so seeing all those things, he was humiliated, means he was blamed by that person in front of everyone, saying that he is a stupid or and he made them to that lawyer made Lee DeForest to feel ashamed in front of everyone by saying that he has used some fraudulent means and misled the people to invest his company. But if he would have stopped, means now today we won't have this type of great invention today for us, isn't it? So even Lee DeForest also, he didn't stop at his failure. He tried and he succeeded in his life. A New York Times editorial on December 10, 1903 questioned the wisdom of the Wright brothers who were trying to invent a machine heavier than air that would fly. 1 week later at Kitty Hawk, the Wright brothers took their famous flight. A New York Times editorial on December 10, 1903 questioned the wisdom of Wright brothers. These Wright brothers were trying to invent a machine which is heavier than air and that would fly. Means what it is? It is a plane, isn't it? So see here, a New York Times editorial on December 10, 1903 questioned the wisdom of the Wright brothers who were trying to invent a machine heavier than air that would fly. 1 week later at Kitty Hawk, the Wright brothers took their famous flight. Though after New York Times has questioned the Wright brothers saying that how it is, means they have questioned them that how a machine can fly in the air, that too which is heavier than air. Then after all those questions and all those things, after 1 week they have took their famous flight where at Kitty Hawk the Wright brothers took their famous flight. Colonel Sanders, at age 65, with a beat-up car and a $100 check from Social Security, realized he had to do something. He remembered his mother's recipe and went out selling. How many doors did he have to knock on before he got his first order? It is estimated that he had knocked on more than 1,000 doors before he got his first order. How many of us quit after 3 tries, 10 tries, 100 tries, and then we say we tried as hard as we could? So about another person. Before we have learned about 3 persons, who they are: Abraham Lincoln, and the second is Lee DeForest, and the third is Wright brothers, and the fourth is Colonel Sanders. He, at the age of 65, with a beat up car and a $100 check from Social Security, he realized he had to do something, and he started what? He remembered his mother's recipe and he went on selling. How many doors did he knock on before he got his first order? Means before he got his first order, can we imagine how many doors he have knocked? It is estimated that he had knocked more than 1,000 doors before he got his first order. Means before he got his first order, he has knocked, means he went to 1,000 doors, means he went to almost 1,000 people and he knocked their doors for selling his recipe. So after the thousand doors he got his first order. How many of us quit after 3 tries, 10 tries, 100 tries, and then we say we tried as hard as we could? Whereas now you only think yourself, how many times we try? For example, now if you are learning a particular answer or you are trying to understand a particular lesson, what you do? You read once or twice. If you are able to understand, it is okay. And if you don't understand, you say that I have tried hard but I am not understanding that so-called particular lesson. But here he was keep on trying for 1,000 times. Normally what we say, we try for one time, we try for 3 times or 10 times or 100 times, and then we say we tried as hard as we could but we couldn't. So but he didn't say that, he was keep on trying, and finally after the thousand attempt, he got his first order. As a young cartoonist, Walt Disney faced many rejections from newspaper editors who said he had no talent. One day, a minister at a church hired him to draw some cartoons. Disney was working out of a small mouse-infested shed near the church. After seeing a small mouse, he was inspired. That was the start of Mickey Mouse. Here it is about another person, who Walt Disney. I think you are very much familiar about this name, because everyone like cartoons. Everyone like to watch cartoons, and everyone like Mickey Mouse. Normally, if we say cartoons, first thing we will come. What will come into our mind? Mickey Mouse. So that person about whom Walt Disney, even he also not succeeded in his first attempt. See, as a young cartoonist, Walt Disney faced many rejections from newspaper editors. Even he also faced so many rejections from newspaper editors who said he had no talent. Everyone used to say that he is not having any talent. But today he is a famous person, and he is the one who started the cartoons, isn't it? So one day a minister at a church hired him to draw some cartoons. So one day he asked him to draw some cartoons. While he was working out of a small mouse infested shed near the church. After seeing a small mouse, he was inspired. While he was drawing some cartoons, he saw a small mouse and he was inspired. That was the start of Mickey Mouse. Successful people don't do great things. They only do small things in a great way. One day, a partially deaf 4-year-old kid came home with a note in his pocket from his teacher. "Your Tommy is too stupid to learn. Get him out of the school." His mother read the note and answered, "My Tommy is not stupid to learn. I will teach him myself." And that Tommy grew up to be the great Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison had only 3 months of formal schooling and he was partially deaf. Here, what they are saying, successful people don't do great things. They only do small things in a great way. Is it true? Yes, because see, सक्सेसफुल पीपल एक्चुअली दे डू ग्रेट दे डोंट डू ग्रेट थिंग्स दे डू ओनली स्मॉल थिंग्स इन अ ग्रेट वे मीन्स द वे ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दोज थिंग्स आर वेरी ग्रेट हियर And here we are going to read about another person who is Thomas Edison. But till now we have read about Abraham Lincoln, Lee DeForest, Wright Brothers, Colonel Sanders, Walt Disney, and now Thomas Edison. One day, actually, Thomas Edison was a partially deaf kid. So one day, a partially deaf 4-year-old kid mean when he was at the age of 4 years his teacher has written a note and kept in his pocket. What was that note? Your Tommy is too stupid to learn. Get him out of the school. So his teacher wrote a note that your Tommy is too stupid. So get him out of the school. So his mother read that note and answered, my Tommy is not stupid to learn. When his mother read that note, she said that his Tommy is not stupid, and she said, I will teach him myself. And his mother started teaching him, and that Tommy grew up to be the great Thomas Edison. Who's that Tommy was? That Tommy is the great Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison had only 3 months of formal schooling. Means he has studied only 3 months of formal means he went to school. And he was partially deaf. He was partially means lightly deaf. Lightly he was deaf. Another one is Henry Ford forgot to put the reverse gear in the first car he made. Here again we will be reading about another person who is Henry Ford. When he invented the car, he forgot to put the reverse gear in the first car which he made. Students, here are some hard words. First is failure, success, defeated, legislative, congressional, senatorial, president, Abraham Lincoln, detour, triode tube, attorney, fraudulent, humiliated, cartoonist, infested. Meanings. Overcome, to defeat or succeed in controlling or dealing with something. Detour, a road or route that is used when the usual one is closed. Triode tube. A triode is an electronic amplification tube having 3 active electrodes, invented in 1906. The triode vacuum tube was the first electronic amplification device. This invention founded the electronic age, making possible amplified radio technology and long distance telephony. Lee DeForest, an American inventor with over 180 patents to his credit. He invented the Audion, a vacuum tube that takes relatively weak electrical signals and amplifies them. He is one of the fathers of the electronic age. As the Audion helped to usher in the widespread use of electronics. He is also credited with one of the principal inventions that brought sound to motion pictures. Fraudulent, intended to cheat someone, usually in order to make money illegally. Colonel Sanders. Colonel Harlan David Sanders was an American businessman and restaurateur who founded the Kentucky Fried Chicken, which is KFC chain restaurants. Beat up, old and damaged, Walt Disney, an American animator, film producer, director, screenwriter, voice actor, entrepreneur, entertainer, international icon, and philanthropist, well known for his influence in the field of entertainment during the 20th century. He created some of the world's most well-known fictional characters, including Mickey Mouse. Infest, to exist in large numbers in a particular place, often causing damage or disease. Henry Ford, an American industrialist, the founder of the Ford Motor Company and sponsor of the development of the assembly line technique of mass production. He did not invent the automobile, but he developed and manufactured the first automobile that many middle-class Americans could afford to buy. Home assignment is, write hard words and meanings in your notes. Students, I have given you the hard words and also the meanings. I want you to write them in your notebooks without any spelling mistakes, and you have to learn those spellings and write them clearly and neatly in your notes and send me. I think you have understood till here, and we will continue the remaining part in the next session. Thank you. Have a good day.